Hello, welcome to a new module of the course about geographic information systems for archaeological analysis. At this new module, we are going to speak about raster geoprocessing and digital elevation models. So you are going to open GBSig and you are going to change the reference system of the view. We are going to use the same one that we used in the previous modules. And we are going to add a new layer. In this case, it's the same layer that we have used before in the other models, with the archaeological sites of the Zurich area. And we are going to open the toolbox. We are going to apply a density kernel geoprocess. With this geoprocess, we can create a map. We can create a heat map where we can see the areas where there are more archaeological sites. So we are going to open it, and we have the vector layer and the field with the ponderation. So with this the ponderation, we are going to check the layer before. If we open the attribute table, we can see the value. With the same, all the archaeological sites have the same valuation, the same ponderation. So if you don't have this this field, you can start editing, and you can go to the table, and from the table menu you can add a new column with the default value. You can select the same value for all the registers. So in this case we have this field, and now we are going to start the geoprocess. So the field will be the value, the search radius will be 10 kilometers, and we are going to write the name of the layer with the density kernel, with the heat map that we are going to create. So we write the name of the layer. And at the raster geoprocessing tools, it's very important to select the extension. So in this case, we are going to use extend from layer. It will be the layer with the archaeological sites. And the cell size, we are going to select 20. So it's very important, because if we select one, for example, for the cell size, it will last more time. So we have to take it into account. So in this case, we are going to select 20 for the cell size. And here we have the heat map, where we can see the areas where there are more archaeological sites. We also can apply a color table to see it in different colors. So first of all, we have to activate the color table. And we have a lot of color tables by default. So we can select some of them. Digital elevation model screen. We have MDT. We have different with different colors. And we also can edit the color tables manually. So here we are seeing several examples for temperature, etc. And we are going to accept with this one. So we can see the different colors with the areas where there are more archaeological sites. We can see the area where there are more than one in white color. And now we are going to add a new layer. In this case, we are going to work with digital elevation models. If you don't have the digital elevation model, you can create them from a control line layer or from a point layer. You can find several videos about that with GBSig. There are only two or three steps, so you can create this digital elevation model. We are going to select this one that you have in the folder with the cartography of the course. We can load the raster files. We can load them tiled or normally. If it's a big layer, we can load them tiled But if the layer is not very big, we can load it normally. In this case, we are going to work with a small layer, so we are going to load it normally. It's a digital elevation model of the Zurich area, and we are going to zoom to this area. Sorry. We're going to change the symbology of the archaeological sites to see it to see them better on the digital elevation models. And now we are going to apply our next geoprocess. In this case, we are going to apply a geoprocess about, we're going to see here the different geoprocesses that we can apply on raster files here. We also have different, for example, we can rasterize vector layers to create the digital elevation models, etc. And now we are going to look for the geoprocess that we are going to use. In this case, we are going to look for, to search shade, and we are going to look to use the shaded relief. This is the geoprocess that we are going to apply. Double click. We are going to select the digital elevation model as input layer. We have different methods, for example, standard, convenite, etc. We can configure the different angles, and we can apply an exaggeration, for example, 5. You can write these parameters, and we can save into a temporary file, or we can save into our hard disk. In our case, we are going to save to temporary file. Very important, we have to go to the output region. We are going to use extend from the digital elevation model layer. And the cell size, this digital elevation model is 25, so we are going to select this this size. And now we are going to see the results. We are seeing the digital elevation model with the shades. And it's very interesting because we can find archaeological sites in an easy way using this image. In this case, we can find the railways, the roads, or probably an archaeological site. It's a very interesting geoprocess. Now we are going to apply a new one, a new geoprocess. We access to the toolbox. And we are going to see the visibility geoprocessing tool. In this case, it's very useful, for example, to check if the towers, the old towers, can be seen from the different mountains. So, from one tower, we can see the other towers around them. So, if we apply the digital elevation model as input layer, we have different methods, for example, visibility. We have to select the coordinates of the receiver, mobile, and in this case, it's the archaeological site. You have to write these coordinates that are the coordinates of one of the sites. In our view, this site is on the digital elevation model, is this one. So you have to copy the coordinates that you are going to see here. Here you have to copy this, to paste these coordinates. You have to select the height for the mobile and the other one, and the radius. So with this maximum radius, it will calculate the visibility from the selected point. We can save it as temporary file, or we can save it on our hard disk. In this case, we are going to save to temporary file. Very important, we have to just extend from the layer the digital elevation model. And the cell size, 25. If we press OK, it will calculate the visibility, the points that are visible from the selected point. So it's very, very interesting if we want to check if the area, if the other towers or sites are seen, are watched from the selected point. We are going to do the raster properties because we want to apply transparency. We have a black image with the parts where are visible, and we are going to apply a transparency by pixel. In this case, we press add to the 000 color, and here we have transparency for black color. We only can see in white color the points that are visible, and we also can apply opacity to the whole image. So we can apply transparency, and we can see the digital elevation model under the our layer. Here we can see the results. And it's a very interesting tool that we can use for our archaeological analysis. We have only 5,000 meters, because we selected the radius, we selected this radius from this point, only 5,000 meters. And with this, we are finishing this model. Thank you very much.